This segment brought to you in association with Burger King.
It's time now we say good evening to Damien. Well, Damien, the Windies need another win after that last defeat.
Yeah, definitely, Shane. Very good evening to you. They have to bounce back. Well, the Windies captain, Jason Holder, he's banking on Shea Hope to continue his fine form in the tri-series against Ireland and Bangladesh. Well, speaking ahead of tomorrow's fourth match against Ireland, Holder lauded Hope's consistency over the last 2 years and highlighted his two consecutive centuries in the series thus far. Now, Hope recorded his career-best score of 170 in the opening match against Ireland, along with fellow opener John Campbell, and they posted the highest ever ODI opening partnership of 365.
It was really good to see him backing up performances, you know, the way he's done. I just saw a start coming up. He's the quickest West Indian to 2,000 runs, which is a really phenomenal feat. You know, I saw the list of guys on the TV, and you know, it's really good for him to be in our company. And think if he continues in our vein, you know, he could be arguably one of our best ODI players to ever play.
Meanwhile, Campbell missed out on the second match against Bangladesh, but Holder has revealed that the Jamaican has recovered from a sore back and is good to go.
Performances like that from young players is something that we're definitely looking for. John got 100 in the first game. Unfortunately, he wasn't fit enough to play the second. But, you know, hopefully we can get him back out on the park and firing on all cylinders once more. I'm happy with how things are going so far. I think the guys have been working really hard. They've been very, very disciplined. As I said, we probably weren't at our best in the last game, but we had tons of discussions over the last couple of days as to how we can get better and how we can improve, which is what you want in a young group like this one. So, yeah, I'm very, very positive that we can bounce back against Ireland, and then when we play Bangladesh again second time around, we'll put up a much better performance.
Well, the West Indies have the best net run rate among the three teams, and a win over Ireland tomorrow will take them a step closer to the final. Now, that match is set for 5:45 a.m. Barbados time, live coverage on MCTV's ESPN2 channel. Well, Dwayne Bravo grabbed two wickets as his Chennai Super Kings booked a spot in the IPL finals against Mumbai Indians after a comfortable 6-wicket win today over the Delhi Capitals. Sent into bat, the Capitals posted 147 for 9 off their 20 overs. Risbah Pant top scoring with 38, while Windies all-rounder Kemo Paul scored just 3 runs. Bravo was the pick of the bowlers for CSK, taking 2 for 19 from his 4 overs. In reply, 50 runs apiece from openers Shane Watson and Faf du Plessis was enough for the Super Kings to cruise to 151 for 4 in 19 overs. Since Silas, well, they had the worst start possible to the primary school competition today, losing their first two matches in the Spike Stung zone. CBC's Sean Green was there.
It wasn't the best day at the office for St. Silas and Spikestown in this game against St. Albans in the Yellow Bib. Taking control early, Melina Yearwood with the scoring shot. Arya Smith with a pass on the inside to her goal shooter, Taisha Small, who sends it back to Smith, and she takes the shot and scores. And she's absolutely happy with that attempt. St. Silas now looking to clear this ball, but just couldn't get it past St. Albans. And even when they thought they had it again, it was gone just as quickly into the waiting arms of Navia Jordan, who shot 2 from 3 to give St. Albans the 4-1 win. Another game with St. Silas again looking for some retribution, this time against Elliot Belgrave in the yellow. St. Silas with one of the tiniest goalkeepers you would ever see, not doing well to get past the towering Elliot Belgrave girls. And they took advantage, Shamil Cumberbatch to Valencia Thompson, and they were off and running. Again, the diminutive goalkeeper finding it tough against the taller girls, passing straight to Cumberbatch, and getting it across to Thompson was no problem, netting another one for Elliot Belgrave. Once more, goalkeeper struggles against these tall girls, but this time St. Silas breaks free, well, at least for a moment, until this happened. Now Elliot Belgrave looking to add another goal. That's Thompson. 3-0 at the end of the first half. But in the second half, they needed just one more goal to defeat the winless St. Silas. Elliot Belgrave winning 4-0. Sean Green, CBC Sports.